guys, welcome back. This is part 4 in our series where we learn facial anatomy together. Before we get started, as always, we got my box of questions here, and I thought we would try something new, just a little bit different. Halfway through this video, I'm going to play a five-second segment of a piece of music from a video game, and if you want to try to guess what that music is, you can put your answer down in the comments. So, let's give it a go. All right, today our question is, we have D on movies and TV and film. What is your favorite movie beginning with the letter D? Is it Dumbo? I can never think of any good ones off the top of my head. All right, D movies. What's your favorite D movie? All right, so we left off last time breaking down the major structures of the cranial mass, right? Do you remember we had the cranial mass and the facial mass? Well, last time we broke down the skull, the cranial mass, into these 5 major parts. So if you need a refresher, that video's there. Today, we are going to start breaking down the facial mass. And the facial mass has 10 major structures that we're going to talk about. Today, we're only going to talk about one of them. So that shouldn't be too bad. So we're going to talk about the lower jaw. The lower jaw is the largest bone structure of the facial mass, and it's the only bone structure that moves on the head. You ever think about that? So your lower jaw is the only movable large structure on our heads. All right. So, in general, it's shaped like, let me zoom in here. In general, it's shaped like a horseshoe, as we can envision right here. Okay, so here we have the lower jaw, horseshoe-shaped, attached at the jaw hinge to the skull. We're going to break it down into 4 points of interest, all right? The first one being the chin mound. And the chin mound, let me zoom out just a little bit. Okay, I have a little diagram here drawn of the jaw. Point of interest number 1, the chin mound. This is all fairly easy. Most of this is self-explanatory. So the chin mound, we all know where our chin is, right? If you put your fingers and feel underneath your lower set of teeth, where your lower set of teeth end, there's an indentation, and then there's a protrusion. That protrusion is your chin mound. That's easy, we know that. Number 2, the dental arch. The dental arch is another common sense one. It's just the arch of the lower teeth. And as this travels back, it connects. Well, first it widens. It widens and then connects to 2 broad plate-like structures called the ramus. And the ramus, R-A-M-U-S, connects to the jaw hinge. And the jaw hinge, if you want to feel your own jaw hinge, it should connect to your skull right alongside your ears, right in front of your ears. If you put your fingers right in front of your ears along the sides of your jaw and open and close your mouth, you'll feel your jaw hinge in action. How exciting. All right, so those are the 4 points of interest that we're going to talk about. And now we're just going to break them down from a drawing standpoint. Sound good? All right, so let me draw this jaw hinge real quick. One there, something like this, something like that, something like this, something like that. So here is a very basic That's really bad. But this is the basic horseshoe shape of the jaw hinge. So staring at this basic form, we can see this is where the jaw hinge would be. This is where the chin mound would be. This would be the dental arch of the lower teeth. And this and this would represent the two plate-like forms of the ramus. All right, let's write that. Let's write the word ramus just for fun. Ramus. Now we're going to look at the jaw in profile. So let's take the head that we learned how to draw in proportion before from the side view, okay? If you remember, we had two eggs if we're looking at a profile of the head. We have two eggs of the same size. We're going to take this one, cut it in half, and to get our proportions, we're going to find one line here, one line right down the middle, one line at the end of that circle, and one line here. And one, two, three. All evenly spaced, somewhat. Okay, so here is the brow ridge. We are going to give this guy a nose. Let's give him a nice nose. There you go, sir. Let's give him an upper lip. Let's give him a lower lip. We come in and then out again for the chin mound. Alright, that's a weird, weird look this guy's got going on. Okay. So he looks strange, that's okay. Alright, let's give him an eye. Ooh, there. Let's give you an eyeball right there. Your lids. Alright. Alright, so that's enough of that, right? So let's give this guy a lower jaw. Alright, so you can see here, I've put together this little head here. These are the points that we're going to look at right now. This is an ear. It's a very bad ear. Here's his chin base, right here. This, we're going to call his jaw corner. Just using what we previously learned, we know that this here is the chin mound. Now from the base of that chin mound, we're going to travel gently upwards to the jaw corner at an angle of about 12 to 15 degrees. It's going to change, obviously, depending on the person, but generally speaking, this rise is going to be 12 to 15 degrees. If this is 45 degrees, right, this is about probably 15. So until we meet the jaw corner, and then we rise steeply, not straight up and down, but something more like that. Obviously it's going to be different based on the person, but once I reach this jaw corner, rise steeply till we meet the jaw hinge right here. So here's the jaw hinge right alongside the ear. Now let's give this guy, let's draw in what his lower jaw would look like behind his skin. Alright, so the lower jaw consists of the chin mound that we talked about. Let's draw that. Here is the dental arch, which is his, what are they called? Teeth. There is teeth. His lower teeth. Alright, and it connects to the, it widens as it goes back and connects to the ramus and then the jaw hinge. Alright, so this is his jaw. Let's give him a little bit of nice shading. Let's get the impression of some teeth. There we go. Looking good, sir. So, this is jaw hinge, right? This is the jaw corner, which determines the jaw angle. Here's the chin mound. This is the base of the chin. We travel gently upwards to the jaw corner at an angle of approximately 12 to 15 degrees. All right, and here is the dental arch, the rounded arch of the lower teeth. All right, that's not too bad. So let's move on. All right, so next we're going to look at two close-ups of the jaw. We're going to observe how that horseshoe shape is being drawn from two different angles. Obviously, we're going to see how it's drawn from all the angles eventually. This is just an overview so we can, in our minds, have a way to understand the concept a little bit better before we move on. In the future, we're going to get into all the small details. Right now, we're just covering, you know, all the broad overview of terms and structures. Like we said, there's 10 facial features, and we need to identify and become familiar with them before we break them down into the equations, the measurements that we'll be using when we draw them. We need to first understand them. So that's why we're jazzing it up with 5 seconds of video game music, right? To help keep our interest. So I'm going to draw these two close-ups of the jaw from two different angles very quickly. So I'll be right back. Okay, so while I'm doing that, I'm actually gonna play three separate tracks from three separate games. All of them are pretty old school video games. But I think they're all pretty easy, so not too much of a challenge for this first one. But okay, here we go. Here's the first one. Do you know what this is from? Alright, and this is number two. And last but not least, number three. So there we go, three separate tracks from three separate video games. Feel free to put them in the comments below. Alright, moving on now. Alright, so, as we can see, at the jaw corner, do you remember the jaw corner? Oh, this. Right here. The jaw corner. The jaw hinge. The chin mound. So, here's that jaw corner again. Here's the jaw hinge. You can see that at the jaw corner, at the chin mound, the base of the chin there, here at the back of the skull, here where the base of the skull meets the ramus and the jaw hinge, you can see 1, 2, 3, for parallel lines. Now, like we said, we're not really going to talk too much about this. We're just looking at this so we can see a glimpse into our future of how we are going to be able to proportion and measure. You can see that it's a little bit easier to understand now that you know, well, if each one of these lines is going to be the same exact, if they're all parallel, well, that takes a lot of the guesswork out of it, doesn't it? So that's the type of stuff we're going to be using when we're tilting the head in various directions, so we can still orient ourselves. Great. All right, so here it is again. Here we are at a different angle. These pictures are a little bit cleaner, so it'll be easier to understand. Basically, what we want to get out of this is that the jaw corners are parallel with the chin, and that these parallel lines aren't, they're always going to remain parallel, no matter which way we shift the head. You can see we shifted the head into a, I don't know what this is called, like a three quarters from behind view, I don't know what that is, but you can see that the parallel lines remain the same. They'll always match each other. So we're going to learn a lot more of these in depth, of these proportion and measurement things. Right now we're just covering the concepts, like we said. So before we end, let's just do a quick review of what we learned. What did we learn today? We learned the chin mound. Well, first we learned that the lower jaw, or the mandible, we can call it, is the largest bone structure of the facial mass. And it's the only movable bone structure of the head. We know that it's shaped like a horseshoe. We know that it has four major points of interest for us as artists. We know that this here is the chin mound. We dip in, we come back out, we protrude. This tight, bony, angular protrusion is the chin mound. Here, the dental arch of the lower teeth, it widens as it goes back, turns into the ramus, these two broad plate-like structures, which rises steeply into the jaw hinge. The jaw hinge, which connects to the rest of the head, right alongside the ear. So that's pretty easy. And then we learned, see this guy, we learned that from the chin to the jaw corner, we rise gently 12 to 15 degrees, then we rise very steeply to meet the jaw hinge right alongside the ear. All right, and then we went over the concept of the chin and the jaw corner, and right here at the jaw, where the base of the skull meets the jaw hinge. No matter which way we turn the head, we're not actually going to do it, but we're just introducing that little factoid. No matter which way we turn the head, those lines will always remain parallel with each other. Okay, so that wasn't, you know, that wasn't a barrel of laughs by any means. Next time we're going to get into the other nine facial forms, and then we'll be able to get into something that I know I enjoy a lot more, and that's getting into the proportions and measurements. See, we have to go over all the terminology just so we can understand what we're talking about when we're explaining the proportion and the measurements. So I'm really building this up, aren't I? All right, so what's your favorite movie beginning with the letter D? And if you know the name of the song that we played in the middle of this study session, let me know in the comments below. I'll have the answer in there somewhere. All right, guys, have a wonderful day. Thank you for watching, and happy drawing. Bye-bye.